Good morning. It's Tuesday, January 15th of 2013. We're coming up to 8 a.m. on the East Coast, and my name's Stephen Whiteside. I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are lower. S&P futures down about 6, Dow futures down about 40. So we are looking for a lower open at 9:30 Tuesday morning. Now, the stock index futures have been slipping all morning, but overnight things were fairly quiet and positive for the most part. Looking at the Shanghai market, last week we talked about the Shanghai market coming down to the lower channel line, but it reversed on Monday, traded higher on Tuesday. And looking at the Nikkei in Japan, similar situation, came down to the upper channel line last week and then reversed. So those markets are still looking okay. A little weakness this morning in the pre-market. Bonds continued to move higher yesterday. A close above 146.10 would give us a buy signal on Tuesday. Remember, we've got this open gap here that could potentially act as resistance on the way back up. Of course, we don't want to see money going into the bond market, because that would probably mean that it would be coming out of the stock market. We still have the U.S. dollar on a sell signal, which is supportive for higher stock prices, and the euro making a higher high yesterday for this move, and that's supportive for higher stock prices. Taking a look at the VIX, we're still on a sell signal here. We were up a little yesterday and been treading water for the last few days, so not a lot of commitment on either side for option traders. S&P 500 still stuck up at the resistance. Now, we closed above resistance. A lot of people ask about that, but if you look at the low of the day, it was actually below that price target line. And so what we're looking for is a complete bar above resistance. And anytime that you're looking at any market trying to break out, that's what you really want to see, is you want to see a complete bar above whatever that price target was. And so we're looking for the low of the day to be higher than 168.75. Looking at the other major indexes, and all of them look pretty similar. You know, we had that big pop, and then we've been basically trading sideways ever since. And I mentioned to people that if you missed the pop and you weren't already in the market, it's probably best just to sit on the sidelines and let things work themselves out. And that's pretty similar for the Russell 2000 and the ZAX Microcap. We've been able to edge a little higher here, but certainly no big momentum to the upside. And so we're looking to see if, things start to break down here. And one of the sectors where we're seeing a pullback right now is in the banking stocks. Still haven't seen any momentum in the gold and silver sector. We need to close above 163.61 to give us a buy signal for the XAU on Tuesday. Looking at commodities, a little bit of movement yesterday. We still have a crude oil on a buy signal here, still trying to get over resistance at 34.38. Gasoline still on a sell signal. Natural gas is on a buy signal. We had a bearish reversal signal yesterday. We have that open gap, and that open gap could act as a support if the market wants to pull back here. But we wouldn't see a sell signal in natural gas until we are below 18.22. It looks like the pros are just about to take control of natural gas, so we'll have to see what happens on Tuesday. Looking at copper, we're back on a sell signal, so we saw some weakness in copper stocks yesterday. Looking at gold, we're still on a buy signal here. A close below 160.46 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday for the GLD. And last time I looked, gold and silver were up in the pre-market this morning. For the SLV, we're looking for a close below 29.24. Next up, let's take a look at stocks, starting with Apple Computer. We're sitting right at 500 in the pre-market this morning. 468.75 is our next target to the downside. While Apple Computer was putting downward pressure on the market yesterday, we saw Dell, big pop yesterday, potential buyout of Dell. And if that were to happen, that would free up a space in the NASDAQ 100. And Dell has been dead weight in the NASDAQ for quite a while. Looking at the CME group, we moved higher yesterday, hit our next price target of 54.69. So hopefully you've got some orders filled up in that area. Looking at Google, down hard yesterday, still on a buy signal here. A close below 723.01 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Looking at Goldman Sachs, nothing going on there yesterday. Nothing going on for Visa. Now, Research in Motion was up sharply over the last couple of days, and some people have talked about, maybe some company-specific stuff going on, and then other people are talking about the fact that it just might be the fact that money coming out of Apple Computer needs a place to go, and it's been going into both Research in Motion and Nokia as potential places to put cell phone money. Last up this morning, quick look at the 60-minute charts and looking at the VIX. VIX has been just lying flat for the last few days, which we saw in the daily charts. It looks a lot worse on the 60-minute charts. A close above 1360, which we'll probably see this morning at the open, will give us a buy signal. That's negative for stocks. If we start breaking out above 15, that would be the first sign that something's about to change. We talked about potential resistance from these valleys here. And then, of course, we have the top of the open gap as potential area of resistance as well. Looking down for the S&P 500, we're already on an intraday sell signal. That would change with an hourly close above 1470.72. For the NASDAQ 100, we need an hourly close above 2739.45 to give us an intraday buy signal. And last up for the XAU, we need a close above 163.80. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. We're certainly seeing a pullback in the pre-market this morning. It's certainly enough to rattle the cages of day traders, but I don't think it'll be enough to set off very many longer-term or swing traders on Tuesday. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Wednesday morning.